Hello, 3D printing friends. Today on the BB3D channel, we'll find out how to disassemble and reassemble the extruder on the Monoprice Maker Select Plus 3D printer. And as a bonus, we're going to learn how to clear a filament jam. Stick around and we'll get into it right after this. I'm Brian, and you are watching BB3D. Hi, welcome back. You know, when you have a 3D printer, it is inevitable that at some point you're going to need to take apart the extruder. Maybe to clear a particularly gnarly filament jam, or for cleaning, or for troubleshooting. And then of course you're going to need to know how to put it back together again, and when that time comes, you'll be glad you watched this video. Assuming you have a Monoprice Maker Select Plus 3D printer, of course, or a Wham Duplicator i3 Plus, or a Cocoon Create Touch, or one of the other printers that all share this design. Because we're going to do all those things I mentioned, the taking apart thing, the unjamming thing, and the putting it back together again thing. So what tools will we need for this? I'm glad you asked. We're going to need the hex wrenches or Allen keys, which came with the printer, and the poker hook, that's the J-shaped wire thing that came with the printer. Here's to hoping you didn't throw it out. If you did, I have a link in the description where you can buy another one for about $4. Okay, so that's the tool list. Now, as I said, I'm going to cover the disassembly, the jam clearing, and the reassembly in that order. So, without further ado, let's take this thing apart. First, with the printer on, set the Z height about halfway up. This will give us plenty of room to work. Then, turn the printer off. Because when the printer's on, the extruder fan is on, and since we're going to have tools in close proximity to the fan, let's not tempt fate. We don't want to break a fan blade. Been there, done that. The t-shirt sucked, so I didn't get it. Oh, also, make sure you've let the printer cool down and the nozzle is cool. We don't want to get burned. And if you have any filaments still going into the extruder, clip it off. We don't want that to get in the way. And you might want to place a small folded towel on the print bed. This will protect it from damage if parts fall on it. And yes, extruder stepper motor, I am looking at you. Also, if small parts fall off, this will help keep them from bouncing around and getting lost. So, while supporting the stepper motor with one hand, loosen the two long screws which hold the fan, heatsink, cooling block, and stepper motor together. And I mean loosen them to the point that they're not holding onto the stepper motor any longer, but don't actually remove them yet. You'll see why in a moment. Okay, unplug the cable from the back of the stepper motor. And then remove it from the right-hand side of the extruder assembly by lifting up. Then you can set it aside. The fan and heat sink should still be connected with the long screws, and the screws should still be going through the cooling block. So now, while holding the fan and the heat sink together, slide those parts out to the left. If you look at the fan and the heat sink, you'll see a pair of cylindrical spacers in between the two. Those little spacers are why I told you not to yank the screws out earlier. If you had done that, you might still be looking for one or both of those little spacers. Trust me, I know. I've done it multiple times. So now that you know those spacers are there, take that fan and heatsink sandwich and place it in the palm of your hand with the heatsink as the top piece of bread. Now you can lift the heatsink off the screws and set it aside with the stepper motor. Now you can remove the spacers and set those aside. Then you can remove the screws from the fan and set those aside. I'm using a rear-mounted blower and parts cooling duct, so my stuff is around behind everything, but if you have the stock parts cooling fan, it's mounted at the front here. You'll want to remove the two screws holding it in place. And this fan you can probably just tuck out of the way up and over the top of the X carriage, but if you want to unplug it and set it aside, you can do that too. Electrically, both fans are still connected to the breakout board at the back of the X carriage. So to remove them, we'll need to remove that metal cover, and then we can unplug the fans. So remove the two screws that hold the cover in place, and you may also want to remove that ribbon cable so you can better see what you're working on. We'll get the ribbon cable up out of the way, and we'll take this cover off. So follow the fan's leads back to the breakout board and unplug the fan from the socket. Make note of which socket that the fan goes into, so when you're reassembling all this, you don't get your fans plugged into the wrong sockets. Set the fan aside with the rest of the parts. Hooray! You have successfully disassembled the extruder. Now let's pretend there's a filament jam down there. Time to get rid of that problematic plastic. Now, I want to start this out with a word of warning. We're going to be heating up the nozzle to clear the plastic, so I want you to be careful. So at the start of this video, I mentioned that one of the reasons you might need to disassemble the extruder is to clear a clog or filament jam. Now, generally, the first step in trying to clear a clog is, with the nozzle at working temperature, to pull the filament out, and then, using the poker hook, try pushing what's still in the nozzle on through to see if we can force whatever's blocking it to squeeze on out. But sometimes that doesn't work, and the reasons vary. Sometimes your printer ran out of filament and there's not enough for you to grab onto and pull back out. And to make matters worse, when you try using the poker hook to push that existing nub of filament down into the extruder, you can't. The end of the filament that's still in there doesn't have a nice flat end on it, so the tool can't push straight down on it. Or sometimes the printer finishes the print job, though having had a jam, the print itself is unfinished. In this case, the filament has cooled down inside the tube between the heater block and the cooling block, and no matter what you try, you can't get enough heat up into the cooling block part of things to soften the filament. And there are probably many other reasons, but let's just say sometimes you need to take the extruder to bits in order to get things cleaned up, and that's why we're here. Now, we've already disassembled the extruder and removed the fan, so everything is out of our way. I'm going to clip this filament off right about where it would be if the printer had run out during a print. So you can see there's a little bit we can grab onto and try pulling out once the nozzle is up to temperature, but what if the filament had snapped off right at the opening? Now there's nothing at all to grab onto. The only way out is forward, and by that I mean we need to try forcing this filament out through the nozzle. So if you unplugged the ribbon cable from that breakout board, you'll need to plug it in again since it carries power to the heater cartridge. And we can remove the towel we put on the bed. We don't want to get filament on it, right? Now let's turn the printer on. And we'll use the filament load slash unload feature because that heats the nozzle without heating up the bed. And again, this is going to get hot, so be extra careful not to burn yourself. Now I'm using the ADV-i3++ firmware on this printer, and if you haven't installed it, I highly recommend it. I have a video covering that process, and there's a link to it in the description. I've set the nozzle to 240 degrees C, which is going to get plenty hot. And because the fan and the heatsink are no longer attached to the cooling block, that's going to warm up too. In fact, that's kind of the reason that we've removed them. Also, I want you to be careful around the rest of the metal here, like this bracket where the stock parts cooling fan mounts. This metal is all going to be soaking up heat, and again, I don't want you to burn yourself. Okay, so once this gets up to temperature, let it sit for a few minutes so some of that extra heat can get up into the tube connecting the heater block with the cooling block. If filament had jammed in that part and then the printer cooled down, we need this heat to get up in there to soften the filament. I'm going to start pushing down on the filament with the poker hook, and that should be enough to get the filament moving. Yep, there we go. Now you can take this tool and poke it down in there a few more times, just to make sure you get that filament down through there. There we go. Okay, now that we've got filament flowing through that nozzle again, let's turn the printer off and let it cool down. If this hadn't worked, we could try using a nozzle cleaning kit, such as this one from Repcord. It has a bunch of different sizes of wires corresponding to common nozzle diameters. You find the one that matches your nozzle, which in our case would be the 0.4 millimeter size, and you poke it up into the nozzle from below. The idea is if there was an impurity in the filament which was stuck in the nozzle, this could help break that up and allow it to flow out. And if that didn't work, we would need to remove the nozzle from the heater block and replace the nozzle. If you want a video showing how to do that, let me know in the comments. So again, make sure you've got the printer turned off and you've let it cool down completely because now it's time to put it all back together. First, let's plug the fans back in. If you unplug the parts cooling fan, make sure you plug the fans back into the correct sockets. If, like me, you only unplug the heatsink fan, there's only one place for it to go. With those plugged in, we'll continue. Next, we want to get the cover put back onto the breakout board at the back of the X carriage. Get that lined up and then put the screws back in. And you'll also want to make sure to plug the ribbon cable back in. The next step is to assemble the fan, spacer, and heatsink combination. So slide the long screws through the fan Then add the spacers. And then add the heatsink. Note that there's a notch on the heatsink for those spacers, so make sure you've got everything facing the right way. Oh, by the way, when you're putting the fan back on, the fan is supposed to blow air across the heatsink, so make sure the label side of the fan is facing the heatsink. Now that you've got all of that assembled, slide that into the cooling block. Now we need to reattach the extruder stepper motor. So let's plug the motor in. And then the motor sits over here on this side. And we're going to hold that together with the long screws. There, that wasn't so bad, was it? You know, one of the things I like about this printer is that basic maintenance tasks like this aren't too terribly difficult. Other tasks on this printer are a little harder, like removing the heated bed, simply because you have to take the bottom panel off the printer to get to the bed's power and thermistor cables. And when you put it back together, that cabling has to go back inside the printer body, and getting it all arranged properly so the cable doesn't snag when the bed moves can be a bit fiddly. Well, now you have the knowledge needed to disassemble and reassemble the extruder. You'll find this handy not only for clearing filament jams, but also when you inevitably need to replace the heatsink fan. By the way, if you do need to replace the fan, I recommend going with a Noctua fan. Those things are super quiet, but they're 12-volt fans, and this is a 24-volt printer, so it's a little more involved than just swapping the fan out. If you're interested in that procedure, I've got a video covering it, and there's a link in the description. Well, we've reached the end of this episode. Thanks for making it all the way to the end. And a big thanks to all of you who subscribed to the channel, because it means a lot to me, and it also helps the channel grow. If you haven't subscribed yet, I'd love it if you would please click the subscribe button down there, and those of you who like notifications can click the little bell to have YouTube gently tap you on the shoulder when I release new videos. Speaking of videos, I do hope you enjoyed this one. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. If not, give it a thumbs down. But either way, leave your thoughts in the comments. If you like the content I'm producing, please consider supporting the channel with a one-time micropayment. You could buy me a coffee or leave a little something in the PayPal tip jar. Links for both are in the description. Well, now that I've got the extruder undisassembled, I'm going to go print something cool. You do the same, and I'll see you next time.